What could a stuffed nose, a migraine, and a toothache have in common? Ear, nose, and throat specialist Dr. David Stepnick is here to breathe new life into our understanding of our sinuses. Dr. Stepnick is with Metro Health. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
And I know this is a problem I suffer from, so I'm glad to have good information. I understand how a stuffy nose could be part of, you know, your sinus issues, but a migraine and toothache, where does that fit in?
Well, Lori, we have four sets of sinuses. There are sinuses above the eyes, between the eyes, beneath the eyes, and behind the eyes. And the sinuses in particular beneath the eyes, the bottom of the sinuses at the same place where the roots of the teeth are. And so sometimes people that have an infection in the sinuses beneath the eyes will experience that as tooth pain. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, though, it is a problem with the teeth, and so we may need an x-ray to figure out what the real problem is.
Which is really going on there.
What's really going on. The second thing that can happen is that there are certain patients that have migraine headaches that have triggers in the nose or in the sinuses, so that people that have sinus problems can trigger migraines. So they're interrelated.
They're all interrelated. It's all in your head, I guess, right?
It's all in your head.
But not really. But are some people more sensitive to sinus issues than others are?
You know, there are some people that have never had a sinus infection, like me.
Oh, yeah, you're lucky. I get them a lot.
And there are other people that have them very frequently. And there are two things that really can predispose somebody to a sinus infection. One is the anatomy or the structure inside the nose or the sinuses. And the second thing is that some people have swelling of the membranes more so than other people that can end up blocking the sinuses as well. And these can be addressed as far as treatment, either with medications or sometimes surgery.
Okay, so surgery to open up the passages?
It is. Actually, sinus surgery in 2014 really does just that. It takes the small openings to the sinuses that can get blocked, and it opens those up so that it's less likely that they're blocked. That's totally different than what we did 25 years ago, where, for want of a better term, we ripped the linings of the sinuses out. So it's a very different procedure. And
sounds a lot safer today.
It's much safer and better today.
All right. So most of us have had colds over this nasty winter that we've had. Now, does a cold automatically mean it turns into sinusitis?
No, it does not. And sometimes when we have a cold, which is really usually a viral thing, mm-hmm. that most of the times it does not become a sinusitis. However, that a cold can turn into a sinus infection. So particularly if somebody has something that's lingering for beyond, say, 10 days or so, that could mean that a cold has become a sinus infection.
Okay. So if you got all that mucusy stuff, does that automatically mean an infection too?
No, not necessarily. Sick mucus is really something that could
so
be...
So sick mucus?
Sick mucus is that stuff that we all think of as mucus. It's that green stuff, the yellow stuff, the thick stuff. We all have mucus, and healthy mucus is actually important.
Okay, so what's healthy? What's that look like, and what does that do?
Healthy mucus is important, meaning that without it, that our sinuses and our whole respiratory system wouldn't function properly. It's part of the immune system. You can think of it best if you sort of take your tongue and wipe the inside of your cheek. That lubrication mm-hmm. is actually healthy mucus. It's not saliva. And that same stuff is within the nose and in the sinus cavities. And again, without that lubricant working, the sinuses and the immune system wouldn't work well.
Oh, okay. So what if we do get sinusitis? I mean, curl up in a blanket with a good book and drink some chicken soup and plenty of fluids and wait for it to go away? Is that what we have to do?
That is important. We know that things that grandma may have told us about mm-hmm. are actually good. And the rest in the fluids and whatnot are important. But if we truly have a sinus infection, that often needs to be treated with an antibiotic. And without the antibiotic, it can actually last longer or even progress into complications.
Okay.
And the one thing we really can't forget is hand washing. If there's somebody at home that has a sinus infection or even any kind of infection and they're coughing and getting bacteria on their hands and then sitting down on the laptop or something like that, that's how these things are often transmitted. So hand washing is very, very important.
Everybody wash their hands. Okay. All right. A kiss may just be a kiss, and a sigh may just be a sigh, but as time goes by, thanks to Dr. Stepnick, you now realize a cold or a migraine or a toothache may not just be what they seem. To find out if these symptoms signify sinus issues, see a physician. My thanks to Dr. Stepnick for letting us be nosy about our sinuses. Thank you.
Find out more by calling Metro Health at 216-778-7800 or log on to www.metrohealth.org. Next, he has something nice to say.